You are watching Prophecy Audiovisual TV. Subscribe, like, comment, and share.
Hello, praise God. This is Dennis Onyamo kutoka Prophecy Production TV. Dago kirego cha asembeo chise cha poro maragoba na ni honte teko koretera umoroberi okuru kuna ama sase. Unumoroberi oko koretera enchiri kera jumamosi. Nika kitu entunda entanga ni kabisa na nika turno mwako kumuhariga ni umwana mwake sana lakini anaitwa Evangelist Shalom Boke. Na ni mwanafunzi ambaye bado anasoma lakini amejawa na Roho Mtakatifu na hakuna kitu ambacho anataka kushare na wewe katika wakati huu. So I believe kwamba tunaanza na wewe na tutamaliza na wewe. Shalom, karibu sana kwa studio.
You are watching Prophecy Audiovisual TV.
Praise the Lord, ladies and gentlemen watching me out there on stage. My name is Shalom Boke. I'm an evangelist preaching the word of God, and I've come today to bless you with a word of encouragement, and I know that you're going to receive something from me. And before we pray, I would like to give you the verse for today, and that is Psalms chapter 91, verse 7 and 8. It says, 1,000 may fall on your side, 10,000 on your right side, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. Amen. Let's pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we come before you this moment. God, even as I'm going to minister to your people, I pray, God, that your grace may be upon us, God. May you touch every viewer, wherever he or she is, God, and God, enable them to understand the message which I'm going to give them, for it is in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray and believe. Amen. Now, considering this scripture, that 1,000 may fall on your right side, 10,000 on the left side, but none of them shall harm you, I like to give you this short story. There was an antelope which was expecting a baby, and it was just in the middle of nowhere. And when the time came, the antelope, still pregnant, almost going to give birth, it was walking and walking and walking. Then all of a sudden, a hunter came and aimed an arrow at this antelope. And this hunter wanted to kill it so that he could maybe have a meal. So the antelope started running while being chased. And in front, there was, all of a sudden, as it was running, it met hand in hand with a large ocean. It was filled with so much water. So behind is a poacher with an arrow. In front is a large ocean. And when it decided to run to the left side, it found a lion. And the lion was really coming. The lion wanted to pierce that antelope and feed on it. And on the other side, there was a burning, like there was something like a fire which was burning. So in short, this antelope was trapped in the middle, did not know where to go. In front, there is a big ocean. Behind, there is a poacher. On the right side, there is a lion. On the left side, there is fire. And so this antelope said, what am I going to do? I need to deliver my baby. I need to make sure this child is safe. And so this antelope said, I don't know what happened, but all of a sudden, it's just decided, no matter what, it's like, it decided to ignore all of those things and it gave birth. And while it was in the process, all of a sudden there was thunder and lightning and it started raining. When the poacher was aiming the arrow at the antelope, because of the rain and the lightning, the hunter missed. And instead that arrow hit the lion, and so the lion died. And that lightning struck that hunter and he died there on the spot. And the rain which was raining, by God's grace, it extinguished that fire. So when the antelope is done with everything, it looked up, where are my enemies? The lion is dead. The hunter is dead. The fire is not there. The antelope just went. Well, it might be quite a silly story. But you see, there is a message from it. In this world, we have so many battles. In this world, we have so many mountains that we have to climb. But it reaches a point that you don't have to climb that mountain. You have to ignore that mountain. Why? Because the Lord Jesus Christ is telling us, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. Anyone who follows me, he shall receive eternal life. you as a child of God, you have freedom to execute that, to do every single thing that you want. But the problem with man today, you just take so many time, you just take so much time concentrating on so many mountains, mountains that you don't have to climb. And by the time you're done with that, imagine this antelope. If it started hiding from the lion, started hiding from the hunter, started trying to maybe put out the fire, then this antelope will not be capable of giving birth and maybe giving birth safely. But when it decided to ignore all of that and just do what it was doing, you can see how things worked out. So today I want to encourage you, my brother and my sister, wherever you are right now, that in this world, there are mountains to climb. In this world, there is nothing that can go smooth for you. You must fight. If Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, was rejected, he had to fight. He had to sacrifice everything. He had to live in poverty so that he could spread the salvation that he wanted. Even the servants of God who we read in the Bible, they had to suffer and undergo so much. Look at Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They had to go into the fire to be burnt. And by the grace of God, they went there knowing that they have the living God and nothing happened to them. Look at even Daniel. He went into the den of the lions knowing that he was having God and that God will protect him. That is what I'm saying, faith with actions. And nothing happened to him. Look at even Elijah. In the middle of 450 Baal prophets, in against the great and mighty King Ahab, he stood all alone. Alisimama solo akasema, I'm serving God and this God is going to bring me. And through that faith, fire came from heaven. So my brother and my sister, wherever you are right now, I just want you to know, if you are serving the living God, if you have faith in God, if you know that this God is a miracle working God, if you know that this God is a mighty God, then why do you doubt? Why do you have to fight so many battles? You waste your all energy doing this and that and that and that. Mpaka mwisho unashtukia, you've wasted so much time which you could have used. Me, as despite my age, despite how young I am, I've really used this Jesus. I've really released everything unto him. My family, the financial life of my parents, my education, my ministry, the music that I do, I have left everything to Jesus. And despite all those mountains, I thank the living God, because after ignoring all those mountains that I didn't have to climb, Jesus Christ did it for me. And I believe that today he is going to do it for you. What you have to do is to just release everything to Jesus. He's going to do to you. And that is why this book is telling us, 1,000 may fall on my side, 10,000 on my left side, but none is going to harm me. Even there is a song which says, Bwana ni mchungaji wangu, sitapungukiwa na kitu chochote. And once you know that, once you believe that, then I want to promise you, you won't suffer. This does not mean that if you believe in God, maybe you're going to be a millionaire, you're going to be rich, you're going to be famous. No, but you are going to get peace. You are going to get something that other people cannot get. And what you're going to get, every person will want to have that thing. And it is because we as children of God, we are highly favored. We are blessed and highly favored. Me, if you greet me, I won't tell you that I'm fine, thank you, the same way people do. If you tell me how are you, I'll tell you I'm blessed and highly favored. Why? Jesus Christ created us in his own likeness. So today, as I finish, I just want to tell you, I know that there are so many battles you're facing. Maybe you're just a youth and you're in your music, maybe finances, maybe no education. Maybe you are a mother, you have some problems with your husband. Maybe you are a man or a business person and there's so many challenges out there. Maybe you don't get profit. You have so many enemies, so many backbiters. You're being betrayed by so many people. Those are mountains you have to ignore. Because if you start concentrating on them, then my brother and my sister, you are going to waste the good time that Jesus Christ, you would have used it in Jesus Christ to do something amazing. So today, the same way the book of Isaiah says, arise and shine, for your light has come. And the same Bible says that you are the light of the world. Arise, shine. Sometimes you just ignore that. When you see so many people are coming against you, know that is the devil. And if you start concentrating on the devil, you're going to waste so much time, which will have been used in the glory of God. So today, as I finish, I just want to encourage you. Wherever you are, no matter what you're undergoing, no matter rough phases you are going through, just know one thing. Jesus Christ is faithful, and he's telling you the same faith that David had. 1,000 may fall on your side, 10,000 on your left side, but none is going to harm you. And so let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I come before you, mighty God, because you're the mighty Father, you're the living God, you're the Lion of Judah, King of Glory, and there is no one like you. Thank you, God, for this verse which you've given us, mighty Father. I know, God, that there is someone outside there, God, who is undergoing so many rough faces, who is undergoing so many mountains that he or she has to climb, oh, mighty Father. But I thank you, God, because I know you are faithful. I thank you, God, because you promised us, God, that if we believe in you, in the book of Romans 10:11, then we are not going to be put to shame. I thank you, God, because you told us, God, in Matthew 7:7, that whoever asks is going to receive, that if we seek, we'll find, if we knock, the door is going to be opened for us. And so, God, for that person who is listening to me right now and is saying, God, I want you to open a door, God, I'm facing so many challenges and so many mountains, God, Father, the same way you did it for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the same way you did it for Daniel, the same way, mighty God, you did it for your servants in the Bible, mighty God, do it for that person, mighty God, protect them, cover them with the holy blood, mighty Father, and manifest yourself upon them, for it is in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray and believe, amen.
We all say amen and amen, amen. Karibu sana, thank you for that powerful word.
Thank you.
Imekuwa nzuri sana, na I know that you have spoken to somebody outside there, na watu wanaenda kubarikiwa kupitia kwa hiyo injili. Unajua wengi wanaweza shangaa huyu mtoto ametoka hapi, imekuaje mpaka anakuja kuhubiri katika studio. Kidogo tu tunaweza tukapata tu kastili kako kadogo tu kidogo. Kuna ambako unakosoma na jinsi ambavyo umekuwa mentored katika mambo na uimbaji, katika mambo na uhubiri mpaka uje kuna you that confidence ya kuhubiri katika studio. Imekuaje?
Well, a brief history about me. Mm-hmm. The same way I introduced myself, mm-hmm. my name is Sharon Boke, mm-hmm. and I'm in Form 3.
Okay, where?
In Kisumu Girls High School, mm-hmm. and I'm 16 years old.
Okay.
And this preaching the Word of God, it started a long time ago. Mm-hmm. Well, I can say from Sunday school, okay. from those small stories we used to say, uh-huh. and I thank God because since then, so many years ago, mm-hmm. since I cannot even remember the exact date. Okay. Just remember that I've been just encouraging people from then, mm-hmm. up to primary school. Yeah. I was the chair lady of spiritual matters,
okay.
where I was in charge of prayer and everything. Mm-hmm. And even in high school when I joined, I thank God because I'm also again in charge of all of that.
Okay, so in school you get a chance to preach there?
Yeah.
Do you get a chance to preach in school?
Yeah, every Saturday and Sunday, mm-hmm. I'm always there preaching, encouraging people. Mm-hmm. And even every day in class, I do it thrice a day.
Okay.
In the morning, after supper, and before we go to sleep.
Okay. Yeah. The other day, I saw you having a crusade somewhere here at Kisii Town. How this thing, does it affect you when you want to preach, you want to sing, you want to do this? Does it affect your education?
No, it does not. In fact, since I started doing this, God has really helped me. Because I can say proudly, the grade I wanted to be, the position I wanted to be, God has really enabled me. Because, you know, at first I was saying the same way I take so much time preaching, yes. singing the word of God when others are reading,
yeah.
then maybe this can affect me. And it reached the time I wanted to stop. Mm-hmm. But there is this fire in me, you see.
Okay.
And the Lord told me, no, don't. Mm-hmm. And the funny thing is that when they're reading and maybe I'm encouraging them, I'm just in front of the class,
yeah.
praise the Lord, the mm-hmm. word says this and that.
Okay.
And when the exams come, my mom can bear witness and everyone, they were all shocked because I was the best and I even received a word and I said, God, if serving you can give me favor also in other sectors
yeah.
that I don't have to work to, mm-hmm. then I just continue.
Okay. Thank you very much. Basi, Yekulunga Prophecy Audiovisual TV ni program ambayo tumeanza ya chukua muda na ni programu ambayo itakuwa ikukuletea mahubiri katika kila siku ya Jumamosi. Tumekuwa na bahati sana kuwa na huyu mwanafunzi mtoto ambaye anaitwa Sharon, na najua kwamba yale ambayo ametufunza hapa kupitia kwa neno yamekuwa mambo mazuri. Sasa zingine kumbe tulikuwa nige eke gusi yani nige Swahili gosege songo igera bantu bandi batu alisiko, lakini maitenga all of you mnatupata. Wacha Mungu awabariki, tutakutana wakati mwingine na Sharon. Sharon ni mwimbaji, ana nyimbo nzuri sana. Na we are coming back to the studio the other day tupate kufanya program yake ya jinsi ambavyo ameanza uimbaji. Mtaona nyimbo zake ambazo ni nzuri ambazo amefanya. She's a very very talented lady na tunashukuru Mungu. We are here to mentor our young artist. We are here to mentor many people. So if you want, you have something that you want to share to people, just come to Prophecy Audiovisual. Here we mentor. So tumekukaribisha sana, tutakutana tena katika kipindi kingine next week ambayo itakuwa Jumamosi jioni kwa kipindi kama hichi. Wacha Mungu aliye juu akubariki. Salome, you have a word to? Kuna neno la mwisho?
Ningependa tu kuwasalimia nyote, mbarikiwe, and to all the youths outside there, just continue serving the Lord and he will lift you up.
Okay. Ujawambia kwamba you are going back to school, maybe they may ask that lady si akuje tena?
Yes, on second I'll be going back to school. But you can always find me here. Yeah.
But you have a YouTube channel if you want to watch your songs?
Yeah, you can find me on YouTube by Sharon Boki. There's my song Zero to Hero, a testimony of what God has done. So just go to YouTube, write Sharon Boki, Zero to Hero, you'll find me there.
I think that song nilikufanya ukaenda State House,
yeah?
We share that in the program coming next. Wacha Mungu kubariki.